In episode 1 of The Story of Nitrogen, scientist Chris Filstrup explains that a lack of the nutrient phosphorus, rather than nitrogen, often limits the growth of algae in freshwater lakes, preventing them from exploding in numbers. To understand why this is, first, you have to realize that some cyanobacteria, a type of algae, can pull nitrogen out of the air, which can remove the limitations on nitrogen they need for growth. Second, it helps to understand how phosphorus and nitrogen move. Nitrogen exists in many forms, within living things, attached to the soil, dissolved in water, swirling around the globe in the air we breathe. The phosphorus that can get into a lake, on the other hand, is almost always found in living things or attached to the soil. When rain or melting snow flows over the land surface, can dissolve some phosphorus out of plants it comes in contact with, or off the surface of the soil, or can just carry soil with it. The way phosphorus moves across the landscape has often been described as a jerky conveyor belt. Water running over the land surface after heavy rains or during snow melt picks up phosphorus, conveying it along until it encounters something like a stock pond, grass waterway, or road ditch that brings the water to a halt. Here, the conveyor belt stops, and the phosphorus gets trapped, at least until the next big rain starts the conveyor belt moving again. Because of this, it can take years for phosphorus to move short distances, like from a field or construction site to a stream or a lake. Even in areas with lots of phosphorus moving off of fields or lawns, most of it may never reach the lake unless it's close to the water itself, or unless storm drains or other infrastructure shortcuts its route over land, moving it directly into the water. If phosphorus, whose movement is so connected to water movement over land, generally crawls and occasionally jogs its way towards a lake, nitrogen, which can move over the land surface, through the ground, and also through the air, can positively sprint. Even the most remote wilderness lake in northern Minnesota or Manitoba is being fertilized with small amounts of nitrogen that originated in a far distant place. In other words, the area that can contribute nitrogen to a body of water can be a large region, while almost all the phosphorus getting into a body of water is confined to the area that would normally drain into it, its watershed. And even then, a heavily vegetated landscape and soils with a strong ability to infiltrate water usually keep most phosphorus out of the water. It's only when those things disappear that phosphorus starts to accumulate in bodies of water and fuel an explosion of algal growth.